If you truly believe that being vegetarian is right, it's not. You, as a vegetarian, you are involved in horrifying exploitation of cows and buffaloes. It's not what they show on TV. It's not what they show in the advertisements. A cow or a buffalo, just like any human woman, has to be pregnant or has to have given birth to a child in order to produce milk. Lactation. All mammals lactate only when they're pregnant or after having given birth. Simple logic, right? How do you think a cow or a buffalo gets pregnant in an Indian dairy farm? We are literally raping Gaumata in the land of Ahimsa. That is literally what we are doing right now. I'm sorry if my language upsets you, but that is the truth. Now just think for a second, if that action that's happening to the cow or buffalo happened to a woman in our country, what would we call it? Rape? But do you know what it's called if it happens to a cow or buffalo? It's called artificial insemination. In the Hindu culture, cow is considered as Gaumata. She is considered as Kamadeno. She is the most divine, supreme of all. In fact, it is said that all the gods live inside her body. And it is said that Gauhatya, which means killing of cows or causing unnecessary harm or pain to a cow, is one of the worst sins, and it is equivalent to the sin of killing a man. Have you heard of this, Gauhatya? It's considered that much of a crime. So now tell me, if this is not Gauhatya, what is it? If every packet of milk that you buy and everything you get dairy products outside, this is where it starts. Now you see, once the cow gives birth to a child, if it is a male child, that child will be sent to the slaughterhouse and be killed. Why, you ask? Because just like a male chick in the egg industry, a male calf cannot give milk. So it's of no use to the dairy industry. These calves are all killed and they're turned into leather shoes, belts, jackets, and purses. In case the child born is a female, she will not be allowed to drink her mom's milk. So that calf is immediately taken away, tied up, while all of her milk that belongs to her is taken, put into packets, and sold to us. This is done to her for around 5 years. Every single year, she is made pregnant. Every single year, her baby is taken away. Every single day, she is injected and she is milked. When this happens to her for 5 years, after one point, she just gives up. Her mind and body cannot function anymore. And when she is no longer profitable to be used for milk, she is sold to the slaughterhouse for beef. I repeat, every single cow and buffalo in this country who is raised for milk is sold for beef. And I'll prove it to you right now. Did you know that India happens to be the second largest producer of milk on earth? And India is also the second largest exporter of beef on earth. It's not a coincidence. Because as I said, every single cow raised for milk is eventually killed for beef. Which is why I say to my audience when I talk to them, even after knowing all of this and hearing all of this, if you still want to continue drinking milk, please eat beef. For the cow, it makes zero difference. For you, you might say, no, 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 that's disgusting. But yeah, maybe for you. For the cow, for her, no difference, because she existed into this world for the demand of milk, and she finally dies for the demand of beef. Is this what we do? Is this how we would treat our own mother? I don't think it's fair to say Gaumata or cow should be treated like mother if we treat her like this. This is not fair. Please have a heart, have an open mind. Thank you for listening. Do think about the animals and what's happening to them. And please consider going vegan. Thank you.